basically the open gyms, basically what I come in early, the open gyms we used to have, everyone used to come on. Like, at least, it was at one point we've had an open gym of 100 people. So it was no way we could manage that many, you know, 5-on-5, you know, and people have quality games. Like, you had no choice but to start a league. You know, there was no way. Like, so we had both of the Grant boys, with both of them coming in, they never stepped on the court. I said they never stepped on the court. We had Thomas Robinson, he never stepped on the court.
Wow.
Like I said, we had people who come from in college now, like I said, I mean, that was then at that time period in the league now that didn't play, you know, that just gonna get on the court.
Think I'm talking about some money? He's on my comment page saying, damn, did he leave some for the rest of us?
Uh-uh.
Nigga, you don't hustle, you don't eat.
Point
you don't
blank.
Hustle, you don't eat, nigga.
Fuck that.
Hustle harder. Never hustle hard as me. Think I do this shit for the money? I do it for
Waited for luck, it never landed. Nah, stuck on your block, forever stranded. Yeah, I live by the 10 crack commandments. Either you earn respect or you demand it.
Shoot, I've been in gym since I was probably 3 years old. Mm-hmm. Largo. I've been in Largo High School since I was 3 years old. My father used to. My father, when we moved to the area, he just basically met with the custodians who we've known for, a long time since I was younger. And they used to have open gyms, Sunday open gyms, and they used to play, you know, every Sunday. Then he got involved in Boys and Girls Club, so I was always in the gym. He got involved with, you know, got cool with Coach Lou, who was the head coach at Largo at the time. You know, from then on, then I was friends with his kids, and so I've always been in Largo. Like I said, I've played Kettering, played basketball since I was like 5. Since I was 5. Kettering Boys and Girls Club, CYO basketball, private school, with the Largo High School, 4 years, 2 years of JV, 2 years of varsity. Honorable mention, all met my senior year. I tore my ACL, so I only played probably 9 games.
Wow.
9 games, finished the season with 20 ACL. Then after that, set out the year to recover. End up going to school for a semester at Shaw University, didn't play. Tried to walk on, knee wasn't strong enough, so didn't get a shot. Came back home, attempted to go to PG. PG didn't play my style of basketball. They played slow. I don't play slow paced games, so I ended up playing. Now even attempting to go a chocolate team. Start playing these men's leagues that at Largo with my father. Like on Sundays, my father they ran men's league for Parker Plant. Playing there. And we're just playing with guys that know me. And just so I used to play there. Pretty good. They enjoyed me by playing. So they was like, why you not school? I was like, there's no schools out here. Especially, this time of day. So one of the teams I play on, he knew the coach at Montgomery College, which was Coach Joyner. Now a part of 6.
Yeah.
He knew him. I've known Coach Joyner, forever. Just because I was at Largo with my father, so I've known, everyone's known me since I was younger.
Right.
So there's no, I'm a little Pettis, little Pettis ain't no big. So, I got a call, go to Open Gym. He loved my style of play, he loved the way I played, so he was like, he loved me to come here. It's not a scholarship, but you can get in and get a scholarship there. So I ended up going there, did 2 years there, graduated with my associates. Stuff ain't paying out. Another bump in the road, stuff ain't paying out, just didn't pan out.
Right.
I had one scholarship, had a few scholarships, D3s, I just didn't feel like going D3 because I already spent enough money already,
right.
So why do it? So I ended up just sitting out a whole year, just working, whatever, and then I ended up finding out I'm having a kid on the way.
Right.
So that was like, okay, well, so now I got to get back to school, whatever. So I ended up going to, ended up playing open gyms, have open gyms at Largo. Right before the league started, I had started having open gym at Largo, was packed, people coming. Then I got a phone call from a friend of mine, Bobby Shannon. He was like, look, I got a coach coming out here from Kansas, D2 in Kansas, that wants to, that wants to sign me.
Mm-hmm.
You got a gym, that we can work out. And I said, yeah, people come going in. So we got like probably 20 people in the gym, and for the coach to see, just to look, So it was me, Bobby Shannon, Boo Jackson, a whole bunch of us.
Mm-hmm.
the coach was like, you know, he liked me, Boo, and he was already there for Bobby. So I was just like, you know, he was like, you know, would y'all be interested in coming to my school? And I said, this is probably July. And I said, so that, I was working all the time, so I wasn't even playing really. So I was still winning, trying to get back in shape. So he ended up offering us a visit. So we ended up, me and Boo both go down there, and we liked it, you know, from something different, you know, small town, country, yeah. You know, just something different from what we were used to, yeah, fast-paced life. So we were down there for a year, for a state in Kansas. We really didn't click basketball. And we just, I think it was more just a maturity thing. Mm-hmm. I said, we both mature when we went down there. Like, you know, me as a father, him is just, you know, it's just jumping school. So like, I didn't even attempt to play basketball. I mean, I probably played the first half of the season. Like I said, I got to play against, you know, University of Kansas, against Thomas Robinson and the Morris twins. I did that. But after that, I didn't have love for it anymore. I had so much off the court issues I wanted to deal with, you know, being a father for the first time, whatever. So much off the court stuff I had to deal with. Basketball was the last thing on my mind. So after that, I ended up, you know, finishing the whole year. I got a medical red shirt, stopped basketball, finished school, came back home. That's all. That's a wrap. I just, you know, forfeited my senior full scholarship. Got 2 years left, forfeited both of them, didn't care anymore. Mm-hmm. Came back home, was going to attempt to play at Stevenson University, where I graduated from. But I was like, I needed money. So I was like, forget the basketball, it's not worth it. Mm-hmm. Basically, the open gyms, basically where I come in early, the open gyms used to have, everyone used to come on. Like, at least, it was at one point we had an open gym of 100 people. So it was no way we could manage that many, you know, 5-on-5, you know, and people have quality games. Like, you had no choice but to start a league. You mm-hmm. know, there was no way. Like, so we had both of the Grant boys, with both of them coming in, they never stepped on the court. I said, they never stepped on the court. We had Tom Robinson, he never stepped on the court.
Wow.
Like I said, we had people who come from in college now, like I said, I mean, that was then at that time period, and in the league now, that didn't play, you know, that just gonna get on the court.
Was it like a certain time frame that they
it was nighttime. It was from 8 to 11.
Oh, that
thing,
yeah.
Yeah, 8 p.m. to 11, if you think about it, there's 100 people in the, I'm not even lying, I have pictures to prove it. It was 100 people in the gym. Every, we had Luke from Louisville, maybe George Mason.
Okay.
When he was at George Mason, that whole George Mason team came there.
Wow.
They brought their first six, they brought them there. They used to play.
Okay.
I said we had the Hampton boys, because all the Hampton boys were from the ones that played against Kyrie and them in the championship, yeah. You know, first round. They are all from here. So they came, they were playing. So we had actual, like, college players coming to play. And I was like, look, it's not going to work. Like I say, for us to play and, you know, get bumped, it's not going to work that way. And I say, then you have people calling BS fouls and being petty. Yeah, that's not going to work either. So I was like, you know, look, what's we going to do? We're going to basically put a league together. I'm going to get refs in here. Y'all just put a team together. We're just going to play. It's better for everybody. Prepping and craft. Don't worry about the BS calls, you know, whatever. You know, it's a little bit more. It more structured than, you know, to get you ready for the season, keep you sharp,
right.
Versus you playing around getting hurt.
Right.
You know, so I mean that's how I ended up starting. And then once we did that, a lot of the, you know, colleges weeded off because it wasn't sanctioned. So I ended up just basically making a high school alumni league.
Mm-hmm.
So I said basically all the high school alumni, I reached out to everybody, say Largo, Oxon Hill, Roosevelt, Parkdale, Duval, Riverdale. You know, all schools in the area, you know, just where, you know, the people still play basketball.
Okay.
So that's how it came about. You say there's no in the area, it's no such thing.
Okay.
I said, I mean, it was just people love basketball. Like I said, because like I say, when you see anybody can, we have a bunch of people that could probably play in the league out here that can't get there. Yeah. People play in college that can't get there. Yeah. So it was just the competition. Like I say, if you gonna come play, even if you weren't gonna come play. And you can get bust, you can get bust. You can get off court easy, you know. But it's just, if you want to play basketball, you were serious, you were there.
Okay.